My name is Scott Haskins. I'm a painting conservator and specialize in murals. I often get asked over the phone how much it costs to remove a mural from a wall from architects, project managers, and from general contractors. It's not that easy. So this video is here to help you see a few of the insights that are needed when you're confronting a project. This first part shows you an easy project where the paint is safe and solid and the painting on the canvas that is glued to the wall comes off easily. Getting the blade underneath the edge of the mural of the canvas and then causing it to come off. You can see that it begins to separate. But the thing that's most important to notice is that the paint is not popping off. It's not cracking, it's not doing anything of the sort. So we're able to simply go through the back, even though we're not able to dissolve the adhesive. We can still break the adhesive because it's brittle. But you can see that it's allowing us to peel it off of the wall without causing the paint to rupture. So as you can see, now I'm further along in the process and going behind the painting with the blade, we're able to lift the mural off and take it off in a very delicate manner, being careful not to tweak the painting or stress it, but in a way that would allow us to separate the canvas from the wall. Once again, this is not a wallpaper paste that you can dissolve. However, it is allowing us to separate the canvas, which in a safe way, which is very important. Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and we're looking at a very nice mural that needs to be removed from a historic building. In the lower right corner of this photo, you can see that someone pulled on the mural to see if it would come off. The result was flaking paint. The paint is so brittle that it pops off. I did a little removal test here with a knife to go behind it, and it looks like the adhesive is probably a lead white paint. Very, very hard. When you have a brittle painting that is glued down with lead white paint, you have the most difficult of circumstances, and trying to remove it will cause the painting to flake and the painting to be destroyed. The cost to do such a very difficult removal safely and professionally will be multiplied by a factor of 10, 20, or even 30 times over the cost of an easy removal. In addition to the cost of the difficult removal, the cleanup of the artwork and removal of leftover adhesives on the back of the mural should be done as soon as possible. Here is an example of what happened to a removed mural with the lead white adhesive residual left on the reverse of the canvas for an extended period of time. Saved from a demolished building, the entire wall was encased and put into storage. As you can see, the canvas was flexible enough to be rolled somewhat as it came off of the plaster with the lead white adhesive still attached to it. But you can see that it was a brittle layer. The surface is white because it has the facing layers on it. Once the painting was pulled from storage, you can see that it began breaking up and was very fragile. The lead white on the back had caused the painting to become much more fragile and now became a jigsaw puzzle to be put back together. This, of course, had a serious impact not only on the preservation of the original artwork, but on the budget. Our first step is to put a cushion layer on the surface of the painting to protect it. After the cushion layers are applied, then we apply what's called a facing. The facing is made up of several layers of paper or also fabric, that are applied with more resin so that the surface is protected. Now, the main purpose of this is that the surface of the paint or the paint layers, the paint structure, is stabilized during the very stressful process. This is an important step when the layers are going to go through a particularly aggressive mural removal processes.
Here you can see we're making progress. We're making sure that we don't cause any damage to the canvas that would result in flaking of paint.
Another technique for keeping the painting and the paint layers safe is this large drum that you see. It serves several purposes. One is a take-up roll, or a take-up reel, of course, and the other is to give us a diameter that will not kink the painting and the paint layers while we're removing the mural. The diameter of the tube is very important in helping to keep the painting safe so it doesn't kink and so the paint doesn't get too stressed. But I have seen some murals that have been wound upon a tube this size. And in fact, I'll show you one. These murals were removed in a hurry before a building was demolished, but the result was the same. The stress on the paintings caused these horrible ripples or these stress cracks throughout the painting. They were very lucky to have not set into motion a very insidious, cancerous flaking problem that usually results. This is what the flaking looks like. It comes off in pinpoint spots all over the painting and flakes for decades.
It came off safely and is now on the tube, which we will be using for transport and for storage.
The deciding factor on using drums and large tubes and whatever we do to murals, we are guided by the fact that we need to make sure that the paint is protected and that the painting is stressed the least amount possible. So whenever we're working on a mural, we think first and foremost, what can we do to safely remove this mural? The main purpose is to get the mural out and preserve the artwork. So everything that we do is guided. So you see the size of the drums or the tracks, for instance. You can see us here putting this large drum on a track with some bearings. And you'll notice also that all of these murals that you're looking at here have facings on them. All of these things are important for the preservation of the paint and the mural. The wall on this painting, for instance, had cracked, broken, and was coming out as a result of an earthquake. And so we removed this mural, then the wall was repaired, and then the mural was put back on. In this case, what was really important was the exact registration. The mural had to go back exactly the same place, otherwise it wouldn't have coordinated with all the other designs around it on the wall. Every once in a while we're working on a project, we run into a situation that was not planned for, but that you should be aware of. In this case, we're talking about mold. In tropical areas, this is most common, where you have a crop growing under and inside of works of art or murals that are attached to walls. Here you can see that the mold is active and in fact practically growled at me when I, when I revealed it. And when we took the murals off the walls, you can see this crop of mold that was there. It's very important to be protected while working on these types of projects. Here we are making progress on the back of this painting, square inch by square inch, removing the residual adhesives after the removal from the wall. We did the work on this painting entitled Aerodynamics for the federal government. It was removed from a location some time ago, decades ago, in a rather rough manner, causing paint to flake and then pinpoint flaking to be active everywhere on this mural. Very difficult but essential condition to stop, otherwise it would continue forever. The painting that was preserved and restored was mounted onto the ceiling of the Supreme Court building in Los Angeles. This pinpoint flaking is caused by a very brittle paint layer that was lifted off of a wall and began popping off. And this paint layer, though in fairly good condition and not so brittle, was brutally treated as it was ripped off a wall. Both of these conditions can be stabilized. This very nice mural by Ramon Contreras was hurriedly removed and unceremoniously ripped out of a building that was being demolished. And in the process, they took a knife and slit the painting in order to get it out in pieces. You can see the edges of the slit that are mangled and have put into motion the pinpoint flaking that I've been talking about. Many areas of the murals have this pinpoint flaking, and the flaking can be stabilized. Here's another one of the panels that was split and or slit and was also mangled and badly treated. And you can see that the final result of the conservation work is really quite nice. I love these murals, by the way. They're gorgeous. They were done about 1932, I think. Another technique for removing murals is to take the entire wall or the entire structure around the mural with the mural. In other words, not removing the mural from the wall. This is particularly important when the structure is historical or when the removal of the mural would cause too much damage. Portrait of Mexico Today by David Alfaro Siqueiros is an important painting by one of Mexico's masters of the 20th century. The entire structure or porch construction, including the walls and the roof and the bricks, were all included in the move that was required. First of all, the porch was enclosed in a fiberglass shell and then was picked up by movers that were specialized in the moving of homes and other structures. Once at the new location, a sky crane was used to lift it off of the semi-truck, and then it was swung through the air and very lightly was brought to rest on the new foundation. These guys were real pros. Well, there's a lot more that went into this project, of course. This lets you see, in a little bit of an entertaining way, one of the ways that murals can be removed from their locations.